Dear students, greetings of the day. Today's session we will discuss about yarn feeding systems in circular knitting technology. So here specifically we are going to discuss about the circular knitting. In the circular knitting technology, what is exactly the yarn feed systems we are using? So what are the different types of yarn feed systems we are using in the circular knitting technology? We are going to discuss in this session. In previous sessions, we have discussed about the classification of circular knitting knitting machines. In the last sessions, we have seen that the classification of circular knitting machines as per the diameter concern and the needle weights used. So what is exactly the classification criteria? We have seen that what are the different types of circular knitting machines, and what are the classification and how we can classify these circular knitting machines as per the diameter concern and the needle weight concern. And along with that, we have seen that what is the basic structure of large diameter circular knitting machines. So today's session we are going to see that what is exactly the feed system is. What are the feed systems we have? So you can see here, the feed systems, how the yarn is feeding to the knitting elements to make the knitted fabric structure. So here you can see here the creel. So the creel, nothing but what? The number of pegs that hold the spools corresponding to the number of thread guides on the machine. So nothing but here, creel is nothing but, it is a metallic stand which is having the pegs. So on the pegs, we can mount the packages on the pegs, so that these packages are going to be feed the yarn into the knitting elements. So generally these pegs are like a stationary creels are generally used. So in every peg, every one package is going to be mounted. So the number of packages mount on the creel is depends upon the number of pegs available on the creel in knitting machine. So there are two different types of creel systems available in the circular knitting machines. One is called as circular track, which is fixed on the upper part of the machine. So at the top side of the knitting machine, we have this creel section. So this creel is having the pegs on the creel, so that on the pegs we are going to mount the packages. And in simple terms, circular rack nothing but, in simple terms, circular rack nothing but the pegs which are mounted on the top of the circular knitting machine. So there are, in along with the circumference of complete circular knitting machine, we have a track on the top side of the circular knitting machine. And the second case is lateral creel. So this lateral creel nothing but, which is generally fixed on the both the sides of the knitting machine, nothing but a side of the machine we have these creels. So again, the side creels also having the pegs where we can mount the packages on the pegs. This is how we can have the two different types of creels available in the circular knitting machine. Now we can see here what is exactly the circular rack is. So the circular rack, which I have already explained, you can see here there are packages which are mounted on the top side of the circular knitting machine, and where you have a bed and the you have a base of the knitting machine here. So you can see the all the zones in the knitting machine which are available, and you can observe here what is exactly the circular rack is. Circular rack nothing but, where the packages are mounted on the top side of the machine. So here in the circular manner, so throughout the circumference of the circular knitting machine, we have different sections. On different sections, we have different pegs. Number of pegs are there. So in number of pegs, you can mount the packages on the pegs. So this is called as the circular rack type knitting machine, where we can see here actual image of the circular rack type, where we can see here the packages, actual yarn packages are mounted on the top of the creel. So this is a one type of feed system, that is nothing but how the packages can be mounted on the top side of the circular knitting machine. And the second case, so before going to the second case, that is the lateral creel type, so why these creel types are two types? One is called as, we are saying that circular rack, and the second one is we are calling as the lateral rack. Now there are few drawbacks in the circular rack type. You can see here the yarn is conveyed from the spool through some yarn tensioners provided with the sensor, which is monitoring and which is going to be feed with the normally into the knitting elements. So the yarn which is passing through the feed system, that is called as the feeders, and through the feeders again, in the feeders and everything, we have the tension mechanism and the sensor mechanisms, where we have like a thread cut sensors. So the thread cut sensors are nothing but whenever, for example, the yarn is having some faults, like objectionable faults, maybe whether it is a thin faults or a thick faults, or sometimes weak places are available in the yarn. So these weak places are generally going to break if we apply the more tension onto the yarn. So because of this more strain applied onto the yarn, because of that, the yarn may get breaks in the creel to the feeder section. Nothing but from the package, the yarn is going to be unwound and it will feed into the feeder. So where the feeder can maintain the tension and it can going to feed the yarn to the yarn guide, then to the knitting elements. So if the tension is more, nothing but you are applying the strain on the yarn. So automatically, if you apply in the strain or stress on the yarn, so the yarn may get breaks if the yarn is having the weak place. So because of this, we required the yarn quality also very good. So yarn quality requirements also very good we need for the circular knitting machine to reduce the number of breakages in the knitting machine. And the second point, you can see here, the sensor activate the in case of knots or yarn breaks, and it will stop automatically. That is nothing but automatic stopping or automatic sensor or stoppage mechanism where the thread breakage is occur. And again, the third point, you can see here, the spool rack is only one system or few systems which is going to be used, because this spool rack sometimes used specific application, like where the rack is going to be rotated. So nothing but rack is rotating, nothing but the cylinder is stationary and the cams are rotatable. So nothing but the feeders are going to be rotatable motion. Feeders are rotary motion, and they, we are feeding the yarn. So if the feeders are rotating, so along with the feeders, we need to rotate the creel also. So if we have more number of packages on the top side of the creel, it is somehow difficult to rotate whole the creel section into the for the feeding of the yarn. So that is the main drawback why we are going for the side creel. And along with that, side nothing but the lateral creels, and along with the lateral creels, now along with this drawback of the circular or circular rack, So we have one more drawback, because if we goes on increasing the number of packages on the top of the creel, so the creel weight is going to become more. So it is somehow difficult to rotate the creel section. And along with that, if for example, if any yarn breakages are occur, so these yarn breakages we have to attend. So if the number of packages are there in the top side, so the worker or the man who is working in the circular knitting machine, so it is very difficult to attend the problem in the circular knitting machine which is having the creel on the top side of the machine. And again, one more thing, whenever the packages are exhausted, nothing but the package, generally the weft package is having a weight of 1.5 kg or 1.8, that is depends upon the customer requirement. If the package is exhausted, then we need to change the package. So for mounting of the package, it is very difficult to mount at the top side of the session. So by these drawbacks, we have the second type, that is called as lateral creel. So in a lateral creel, you can observe here, there are two sessions at the sides. So you can see here, there are two sessions, where you have one session and the second session will be here. So there are two sessions which are generally like, these sessions are generally made up of like a metallic part which is having the pegs. So you can see here, this is called as a peg, and you can see this one is called as the suction pipe or thread tubes. So what is happening is, where the pegs, on the pegs we are mounting the weft package or the package, the yarn package. The yarn is going to be taken through the suction pipe or through the thread tubes. So these thread tubes are made up of like sometimes like it is aluminium, or some we are going to make like a plastic tubes, where the yarn to metal friction is very minimum. So through these suction pipes, the yarn is going to be feed to the yarn feeding system. Then this yarn feeding system, nothing but the feeders which are there. So these through the feeders, where the sensors and the tension can be maintained in the yarn to feed the yarn. Then these feeders, through these feeders, the yarn is going to be passed into the yarn guide, and the yarn guides are going to be feed the yarn to the knitting elements. So this is overall the picture of the lateral creel mechanism, and lateral creel, what is exactly the lateral creel we have. Now one of the major advantage of using these lateral creels are, we will discuss in the coming slides. You can see here the one of the picture where you can particularly observe, there is a creel stand and there are packages where the package holders or cone holders we can talk, that are called as nothing but the pegs. Cone holders or pegs are same. And you can see here the aluminium telescopic tubes where the yarn is going to be passed through these pipes. So the threading can be done with the help of suction pipe system. Nothing but there is a suction aid. So one side of the pipe we are going to give the suction pressure, so that the other side we are feeding the yarn. So by giving the suction pressure, the thread is going to be inlaid, or the thread is going to be laid into the inside of this aluminium telescopic tube, so that the thread is going to be guided. You can see here, the machine with fixed cams can be provided with a spool rack, or in alternative a lateral creel to facilitate the spool loading. So nothing but specifically these lateral creels are used for, like, the cylinder is rotating and feed system is stationary. So feed system is stationary, nothing but creel is stationary, there is no movement to the creel, creel stand is stationary, and the yarn is going to be feed to the feeders also stationary, feed guides also stationary. and along with the feed guides, cams also stationary. So here only these cylinder and inside the cylinder we have the needles. So cylinder and the needles are going to be moved or rotated along the circumference of the cylinder. So nothing but it is going to be rotated. So generally that is why we can call the circular knitting machine speed, that is revolutions per minute of the cylinder we can call. Okay. Then the lateral creel is nothing but what? It is a metallic structure positioned at the both the sides of the machine, as already I told. Then there are yarn guides which are going to be guide and unwound the yarn from the spool or package and positioned to the creel pegs. Then after having passes through the special guides and plastic or aluminum tubes, the yarn reaches to the thread guides onto the machine. So this is just a passage of yarn through the aluminum tubes to the feed system. Nothing but like there is a creel and the creel is having the pegs. On the pegs we are having the package, and from the package we are taking the yarn through the aluminum tubes. Then the yarn is going to be fed to the feeder, then feeder to the guide, then guide is going to feed the yarn to the needles, where the clearing or the needles which are raised and lowering down. So by this is the simple passage of yarn through the some elements, how the yarn is feeding into the knitting elements. Now the yarn is monitored by sensor throughout the path. So whenever it is having knots or any breakages of the yarn, automatically this is going to be stopped. Nothing but the knitting machine is going to be stopped whenever the yarn breakage is occurred. Now, yes, I already discussed here the lateral creels are having some advantages. So what are those advantages? First one is easy of package change. For example, if the package is exhausted, so we can side creels, we have a side creels. So simply by these side creels we can take the package and we can simply mount. So there is no need of the package which is going to be mounted, or we need not have any stools or two ladders are required for the mount of the package. So simply the packages which is going to be mount on the creel easily because the side creels are available because of the side creels. So this is the one of the major advantage, and it is very comfortable to attend the yarn breakages also. So because which is having the complete, the packages are, we can see, we can monitor all the packages, and very easily, for example, if the yarn is break or yarn is not coming to the knitting elements, so automatically the machine is going to stop, and where the LED bulbs are there, wherever the package is, or which package is exhausted, or which package yarn is break. So what is happened? So directly we have a simple signal lamps where LED bulbs will be there, red simple bulbs, so which will blow, and we can directly go there into the particular or respective package, and we can change the package accordingly. So this is nothing but the comfortable to attend the yarn breakages also. Then third one, it allows the drastic reduction of flying dust and the particles in the knitting room. So here, so the lateral creels, we have like generally the circular knitting machines are having within the one chamber where proper air the air is going to be circulated throughout the chamber. Nothing but the suction air is going to be there, as well as the new air will come into the chamber. And the packages which are generally, if we have like sides, so whenever the fluff or fly is generated in the department, fluff and fly, why it will generate? Because of the yarn abrasion between the yarn to the metal parts or elements in the knitting machine. So if the metallic elements we are using to make the fabric, automatically there is a metal to yarn friction. So because of this, the yarn surface fibers are going to be break, and these fibers are going to be very very minute weight, so it will be fly in the department. So because of this fly, generally if we have a top tip, this fly is going to be taken up because of the less weight and because of the air turbulence in the department. So it will accumulate on the packages if we have the top side grip. And if we have a side grip, these will not be completely negligible, but it will be somehow reduced in manner. This accumulation of this fluff and fly on the packages are going to be reduced. This is the one of the major advantage in the quality concern. And the last one, although the creel takes up the larger floor space, the side creels are need more space. If this is one of the drawback, but if we have more space occupied, when it is occupying the more space, if we want to mount more number of packages, then it is occupying the more space. For example, if we have the circular knitting machine having a capacity of 40 feeders and the second machine which is having the capacity of 70 feeders. So now 40 feeders nothing but 40 number of packages need to mount on the creel. But in case of 70, 70 number of packages need to mount on the creel. So automatically, if we have 70 number of packages need to mount on the creel, so the package, that creel size is going to become bigger. But we can accommodate, we need to see that we can accommodate more number of packages on the creel. So more number of feeders we can use. If we use more number of feeders, automatically our production capacity of the circular knitting machine is going to be very very higher. So this is the one of the major advantages. So these are the advantages of circular knitting machine which is having the side creels, that is lateral creel. There are two different types of creels. One is circular rack type and the second one is lateral creel type. Circular creel type is nothing but the creel or the packages can mount on the top side of the knitting machine, and the lateral creel nothing but side creels. We have side of the machine, we have the creel sections. On these creel sections we can mount the packages. These are the two different types of creels generally we are using in the any circular knitting machine, whether it is a single jersey circular knitting machine or in the double jersey circular knitting machine. So as I already discussed, the more advantages are there in the case of like a lateral creel. So nowadays the maximum MNC companies or maximum companies where these single jersey fabrics and double jersey fabrics are manufacturing, they are preferably going for the lateral creel type. This is the, because of these advantages, they are going for the lateral creel mechanism. Now the next one is called as yarn feeder. What is exactly the yarn feeder is? Now the yarn feeder is nothing but, so the packages we have discussed like a creel, right? So what are the different types of creels? So creel nothing but only to mount the package. So this will hold the package and the yarn is going to be unwinded from the creel. From the creel we are unwinding the yarn and we are feeding into the yarn feeder. So this feeder is very very important in terms of maintaining the yarn tension in the yarn. So these yarn tension are directly influencing the loop length as well as the fabric quality. So these are very important. Okay, so the yarn feeder is very important. Now here the yarn feeders are divided into two types. One is called as a positive yarn feeder and the negative type of yarn feeder. So this is depends upon the what type of feeding system we are using and how uniformly we are feeding the yarn to the knitting elements. This will be decided. So whether we are feeding in the negative manner, nothing but yarn is pulling out from the package, nothing but yarn is unwinding from the package by pulling force. So that is nothing but the negative. And directly we are feeding into the needle. So the needle is pulling, nothing but the tension applied on the needle as well as the yarn. So this is called as the negative. We will see that what is exactly the negative and what is exactly the positive yarn feeder is. So what is exactly the yarn feeder, that to negative type of yarn feeder? So you can see here, when the needle takes the yarn directly from the package, so again, when the needle takes from the yarn, when the needle is takes the yarn directly from the package, nothing but package is there, needle is here. So the knitting nothing but loop formation. So when the loop formation will occur, we need to feed the yarn. So the needle is taking the yarn from the package directly during the stitch formation step. So nothing but intermediately there is nothing, there is no mechanism is available. Directly the yarn is taking or withdrawing from the package by the needle. So this is the negative type of feeding system, because now you observe that how much amount of yarn is need to unwind from the package, that is depends upon the, again, the stitch length. What is the length of the loop? So if the length of the loop is bigger, we need to pull the yarn more amount. If the length of the loop is smaller, we need to pull the yarn very small amount. So there, if we are pulling the yarn or if we are unwinding the yarn from the package directly with the help of needle, so it is very difficult to maintain the yarn tension as well as the length of yarn which is unwinding from the package. That is one of the major drawback here in case of negative feeding system. So this is the negative feeding system. You can observe here, like there is a package, and the package, from the package the yarn is going to be taken through some tensioners and through the sensors where the yarn thread break sensors are there. Then the yarn is going to be fed by the help of yarn guide system. So this is the negative type of feeding system. So because of these drawback, like tension cannot be controlled and the loop length also cannot be controlled, so because of that, the difference of the yarn length for the loop formation is going to be occur. So the variable tension of the yarn, since a new spool has a certain diameter, sometimes, for example, if the package diameter is bigger and if this package diameter is smaller, now because of the bigger diameter, the yarn length which is unwinding from the package is going to be different. So now the variable tension, that is called as the diameter, is varying step by step when the yarn is withdrawing. So variable tension of the yarn, since a new spool has a certain diameter which is gradually reduce the yarn unwound and feed into the machine. So this is how I told that the yarn length and the loop is going to be different in the loop formation time. And the second one is the tension directly influences the package hardness. If the package is having harder then and smoother, it is going to be vary the thread tension in the feeding system. Now, so these feed systems, along with these negative feed systems, we have a positive feed systems where the differences of the yarn length and the tension while loop formation can be controlled. Okay, so there are three different types of positive feeding systems. We can say these are for positive feeding systems, but in the positive feeding systems itself, it is having a three different types. The first one is called as tape feed mechanism. Second one is motorized yarn accumulator, and the third one is positive feed system. So once again I am repeating: tape feed mechanism, motorized yarn accumulator, positive feed system. These three are the positive feeding mechanisms. Now we will see here one by one what is exactly the tape feed mechanism, motorized yarn accumulator mechanism, and as well as the positive feed system is. First one is tape feed mechanism. You can see here the diagram which is showing a feed wheel and a tape. So there is a drive tape and there is a feed wheel. So you can see in the image, the yarn is coming from the package and which is going to be delivered into the yarn guide to the feeding of the needle, to feed the needle. So now there are two simple elements. One is called as a feed wheel, the second one is called as the drive tape. So in between the feed wheel and the drive tape, our yarn is going to be laid in between that. So now the feed wheel is rotating and the belt is rotating. Now what will happen? The feed wheel along with the feed wheel, drive tape also going to be rotated. In between these two, we have a yarn package. So automatically yarn is going to be pulled or unwound from the package. So nothing but directly needle is not pulling the yarn from the package because the yarn path is too long. So if we are pulling the yarn directly from the package, because of the more length from the package to the needle, so more tension is going to be applied or it cannot be controlled any tension. Now this mechanism, by using this positive feeding system, so now particularly here yarn is pulling out these positive feeding mechanisms. So this tape type of feed mechanism is having a feed wheel and the drive tape. In between the feed wheel and drive tape we have the yarn, so we are passing the yarn. So if these two are rotated, the yarn is going to be pulled or unwound from the package and it will be delivered into the guide to the needle. So this is a simple mechanism where we have a tape feed mechanism. So you can see, so at the top of the top side of the machine, this feed mechanism is going to be mounted. So you can observe specifically, there are guide rollers, there are guide rollers, so completely at the top side. So don't forget, this mechanism is on the top side. Okay, because I told lateral creels are going to be used, so lateral nothing but side creels. So the yarn is going to be passed through the pipes, then through the pipes this feed mechanism is there. So this feed mechanism is having certain places, these feed plates, that feed tape, as well as the wheel. So if we have 60 number of packages, 60 number of feeder, 60 number of feeding systems should be there. So this is simple. Like if we have 60 packages, 60 feed wheels should be there, 60 feeders are available, 60 places the feeding guides will be available. So that the 60 places we are going to, nothing but in one rotation of the cylinder you are making the 60 number of courses by using 60 number of feeders. So this is the one type of feeding system. Then we'll go for what is exactly the drawback of this system. So advantages are okay, positive type, this is a positive type of mechanism, and yarn is going to be unwound from the package by means of the wheel and tape. And apart from the advantage, we have a drawbacks to overcome and to improve the quality of the fabric. Now what are those? Due to the slippage, nothing but there may be chances of slippage in between the drive tape and the feed wheel. Okay, so between the feed tape and the drive tape, maybe the yarn is going to be slipped. So yarn feed rate can be affected or altered. Okay, so because of the slippage, may be chances of yarn feed rate, that is nothing but yarn length which is unwound from the package or feed rate to the needle is going to be varied or altered. That is one of the drawback. Then the quality wheel cannot be adjusted while machine being operated. So quality cannot be controlled or cannot be changed while the machine is running. Then yarn faults cannot be detected before the knitting wheel. So yarn faults cannot be detected before the knitting wheel. So it is not possible to observe or see the what are the yarn faults which are available or which are there in the feed package. So by these drawbacks, again the second case, that is motorized yarn accumulator, is came into the picture. So now what is exactly the motorized yarn package or yarn accumulator system is? So the motorized yarn accumulator levels off the yarn tension since when rotating, and it accumulates a certain quantity of yarn on the constant diameter of the pulley. Simple, nothing but we will see here what is exactly the yarn feeder is. So here, so there are a driven pulley. So you can see that there is a clip, there is a clip stand, knot catcher, nothing but knot catcher, nothing but if the slubs are or thick places or knots are there, it will catch and it will detect. And there is a yarn tensioner, then top stopper, then winding wheel. You see that the winding wheel. So this winding wheel is going to be accumulate certain length of the yarn. So you can see this picture. The yarn which is coming out from here through the sensor, through the tensioners, then yarn is going to be wound into the wheel. So where this in the wheel, the yarn is going to be winded into a particular certain length of yarn is going to be winded on the wheel. So whenever we required to feed the yarn, that time from the wheel this yarn is going to be unwound and it will feed to the system. So that is going to be happen in case of this yarn accumulator system. So the second point, you can see the yarn wound on the accumulator is then conveyed to the thread guide, always maintain the same tension, and machine takes up the yarn gradually emptying the accumulator. Then so nothing but yarn is going to be withdrawn gradually from the wheel, and once the wheel is going to be unwinded certain length of yarn, then accumulator will again wind some of the yarn into the wheel from the package. Nothing but here it is withdrawing, here it is coming and it is winding on the wheel. So that is the happening. From the package yarn is coming and winding onto the wheel. From the wheel yarn is going to be delivered into the feeding system. That is nothing but feed guide to the needles. So these are the simple parts which are available in this mechanism, and this is how the complete mechanism is available. Now, as I already told, the yarn wound on the accumulator from the package, then there is a thread guides, then the thread guide is going to take up the yarn. So machine takes up the yarn, nothing but from the thread guide machine is going to take up the yarn, machine nothing but needles are going to take up the yarn. Then once the certain length of yarn is completed or unwound from the accumulator, again the accumulator is going to accommodate few layers of the yarn into the accumulator. So this is how the complete mechanism is. Now this is a simple 2D diagrammatic representation, how the yarn is coming and how the yarn is winding into the wheel and the yarn is delivering to the needle. And few mechanisms are there, like a lycra attachment. So as you know that spandex and lycra are a very major amount of these lycra yarns are used in stretchable garments, where these lycra is one of the major factor, where stretchable jeans and t-shirts, okay, leggings, everything, there are like leisure wears, undergarments, they are using the lycra is one of the yarn, like one of the component in the yarn. Not completely the lycra is one of the thing, but particular few applications maybe they will use, but for particularly apparel point of view, the cotton along with the cotton, they are going to be used lycra also. So the lycra, you know that the stretchable, it is stretchable like elastic. So it is having the elasticity of like 400 times to 500 times. Nothing but, for example, if you have 1 centimeter length of lycra, it is going to be extended up to 5 centimeter. For example, if you have 1 meter of lycra length, you can extend up to 5 meter length. So this is the advantage. And again, it will 100% it will recover to its original position whenever you are going to release the tension which is applied on the yarn. So the recovery is 100%, and you can stretch 500%. So that is one of the property of lycra. So for these, for example, if you apply a small tension on the yarn, also going to lead the elongation of the yarn. So if you elongate and feed, then the fabric properties are going to be changed. So because of that, there is a small mechanism where the lycra package is positively driven, and this yarn is going to be feed to the needle system. So that is the simple mechanism. We have a simple mechanism for the lycra attachment. And coming to the third category of positive feeding mechanism, that is positive feed system. So in the previous cases, like so specifically the accumulator type of feed system is going to be used whenever the loop length or a particular specified yarn length unwound from the package or from the positive feed mechanism is there. In that case, they are going to for the positive feeding system. But sometimes in between, if we want, if we alter the stitch length, if we alter the loop length, then this mechanism will not be work. So we need a positive feeding system. Positive feeding system, nothing but it will be a synchronous system, synchronized to actually there is a mechanism like whatever the yarn length we need. So the certain length of yarn will be delivered from the positive feeding system. So the positive feeding system, from where the yarn will be fed? From the package. From the package, the positive feeding system, the yarn will be fed. The yarn, this yarn is going to be positively fed into the package. Whenever if we have more stitch length or less stitch length also, we can alter automatically by using this mechanism. You can see this one, this is the positive feeding system where we have variable motors, or that is servo motors. Can be alter the speed and the rotation, or the if we alter the speed or rotation, automatically the delivery of yarn is going to be varied. So it can be altered. So automatically the length of yarn which is unwound from the packages are going to be altered easily. So that is a one of the system. So that is just like I have given what are the parts which are available in the positive feeding system. So you can see here the dry wheel system, that is consists of two conical toothed wheels, and thread passes between the two wheels, and the quantity of yarn can be adjusted by changing the wheel speeds. Okay, that is the thing. Then the system grants a smooth feeding of yarn on all the feed systems. Then the belt makes a spool rotate, and the number of rotating spools corresponding to the number of feed system. So that I already told, number of packages are equal to number of feed systems or feeders. Then number of feeders are equal to number of feed guides which are there in the needle bed or in the base of the machine. So these are same. And by adjusting the belt RPM, the quantity of thread can be increased or reduced. These are the things about the positive feeding system. Now, from the positive feeder, what and how this yarn is going to be exactly feed the needle. So here you can see on circular knitting machine, each thread guide corresponding to a feed system. Nothing but, like I told, number of packages is equal to number of feeders, number of feeders is equal to number of thread guides. So thread guide, particularly thread guide, you can see which is going to feed the yarn to the needles. So that is the thing. Now thread guide is a steel or ceramic plate with a small perforation or hole for the thread guide or passages of the thread. So it is like a simple metallic part, like a steel or ceramic, and there is a small hole so that the yarn can be passed through this hole so that it can guide properly to feed the needle. Then the thread guide is positioned near to hook of the needle, and so near the needle hook, nothing but, so needles are going to be raised up slowly and lower down. So when the needle is rising up and the needles are lowering down, when the needle is lowering down, there is a hook in the needle. So we are feeding the yarn particularly just beside of the needle. So the needle is going to hold the yarn and it will form the new loop. That is going to be happening. We will see here the guide for single bed circular knitting machine. Now again, circular knitting machines are different types. Three different categories. One is called a single cylinder, cylinder and dial case, double cylinder case. We will see that what is exactly the guide which is going to be used for single bed as well as the double bed circular knitting machines. So this is specifically the single cylinder or single bed circular knitting machine we have. You can observe the guides which are there and which is feeding the yarn to the needles. You can see that the needles are there and the yarn, particularly you can see that whenever the needles are rising and the lowering position, we have the guide. So every clearing and lowering down position, we should have a guide. That is why in the previous slide I told number of guides and number of thread guides are equal, number of feeders and number of thread guides are equal. That is the major point. Now you can see in a closed loop how the yarn is going to be nearer to the particular knitting machine or needle. Now you can see here specifically there are yarn guides and there are feed guides. So the feed guides are just aligned into the side of the needle so that the yarn can be fed to the needles. So this is how the feeders are going to be mounted. That feeders nothing but, once again, feeders nothing but thread guides. So actual positive feeding systems which are there on the top side, now these are called as the thread guides. From the feeders, the yarn is going to be passed through the thread guides. Then these thread guides are fixed on the throughout the circumference of the cylinder. This one is called as the feeder ring. So because this part is feeding the yarn and which is in a throughout the circumference of the cylinder, so it is circular motion. So this is called as the feeder ring. So you can see that the total n number of feeder rings feeder thread guides are there. So feeder is equal to number of thread guides. If we have 50 number of feeder, 50 number of thread guides should be there. Now you can see that the next one is guides for double bed circular knitting machines. So double bed circular knitting machines, we have cylinder as well as the dial case. And cylinder as well as the dial case, nothing but two needles which are there in the 90 degrees angle. So it will be like a one opposite to other or one between the other, nothing but staggered in position or aligned in position. So staggered in position will be there for the rib kind of structures, and aligned positions will be there. But in aligned position, so every time or all the needles at a time, it cannot be raised. If it raised at a time, these needles are going to break, nothing but it will touch together. So because it is aligned properly, right? So alternative needles of dial and cylinder is going to be operated sequentially, nothing but 1, 3, 5 of the dial, 2, 4, 6 of the cylinder will be operated at one time. I think I am clear to this point. So this point we can see here of how these double weight circular knitting machine, how these yarn guides will be used. So this is how the yarn guide is using in between the needles of the cylinder as well as the dial. In between these two we are feeding the yarn. So that is how the yarn feeding is happening. So you can close look this image. So the same thing what I explained is, you can see here. So the thread guides of double bed machines feature two holes. One is used for the conveying of yarn to the cylinder, and the second one is preferably for the dial. Okay. And some machines have more thread guides for same feed system. Example, circular knitting machines for continuous fabric or continuous striped jersey fabrics or jacquard selection systems. Like if you want stripe patterns or multi level stripe patterns, then you need to go for the stripers. So we will see that what is exactly the striper is. So this is called as auto striper. So we will see here what is exactly the auto striper is. Auto striper is nothing but, you can see that there are multiple colors which are there in the one position. So whenever we require a particular color of yarn, the particular thread is going to be selected and it is going to be feed to the needles and it will make the loops. So this multicolor or specifically this auto striper is going to be used for the multicolor system. So multicolor system, if we want multicolors, so for example 10 courses is one color, 20 courses is on second color, 60 courses are third color, like that if we have a pattern, okay, non-equal patterns or equal patterns. Equal patterns is nothing but 20 courses of one color, second color 20, 30 second, nothing but third color is 20 courses. So each color is having 20, 20, 20 or 30, 30, 30. That is called as equalized stripes or nothing but uniform stripes. So ununiform stripes nothing but like first color is having only 5 courses only, and second color we need 10 courses, and third color we need 20 courses. In that case we need to alter. So both the cases we need to alter the color change, or particularly the color selection should be happened. So by this we need to have a auto striper mechanism. So this having a sensory mechanism, like where the there are like 4 to 6 number of fingers. So this four to six number of fingers are going to be operated by electronic means, by operating the programmable microcomputer or microprocessor which is equipped with the knitting machine. So whatever the patterns we need is going to be given into the microprocessor unit, so that the microprocessor will select and deselect the auto striper mechanism, so that the fingers are going to be move up and down, so that the particular yarn is going to be fed to the needles. So this is how it is happening in the using of auto striper mechanism. So this is some of the references for particularly what is exactly the type of feeding systems we have and what are the different types of feeders we have into the circular knitting machine, that to the circular knitting machines with single jersey, that is single cylinder or single needle weight and double needle weight circular knitting machines So these are the things. Now these are the few references, and thank you. So thanks for listening. Coming sessions we will discuss about more things about the circular knitting machine. So till then, thanks for listening. Bye.